Welcome to Book Club Preview. I'm Michael, and today we're looking at Lab Girl, Chapter 2. Oh, and 3. It starts off with the author talking about this blue-tinged spruce, which is this huge tree that I guess they have in their yard. And this tree was kind of like her best friend. If you've ever read the book The Giving Tree, it really sounded a lot like that, where when she was young, she would hug the tree and have tea parties with the tree and climb the tree. And then she grew older and realized the tree didn't really care for her because it was a tree. But she still just really loved this tree and had a really special connection to it. And then she starts talking about the life cycle of plants in general, of just how incredible it is that this tiny seed can wait for hundreds of years, and then something trigger the right conditions, and that tree grow into something huge. And this life cycle, she compares it a lot to human life cycle. So as she's talking, it almost sounds like maybe she's talking about her own adolescent life. The tree has an awkward stage, a weak stage, being the same size but just getting fatter stage, all different parts of the life cycle of this tree. Well, she ends the chapter by talking about this really tragic event where spring looked like it was going to come early and the tree started to grow some leaves and branches. But then snow, heavy snow fell, and the snow kind of was too much weight for the tree, and it collapsed over, or his branches broke, and the parents had to cut down the tree. And she found that out like 9 months later after it was already done. Oh, I wonder if she cried. Well, she goes on to the next chapter, talking about seeds and the timing that seeds have. Of really just being able to wait, and how this shell provides this unknown trigger to open up the plant. And I thought it was really interesting how she described that the outside of the shell actually keeps the plant from growing, maybe more than just protecting it from predators or something. She talks about these seeds and growing all over the world, being protected, growing in different ways, and, you know, all sorts of different kind of aspects of the timing and the way that the seeds grow. Well, one interesting story that I really connected with was here at the end, where she talks about this lotus seed. And this lotus seed they found was 2,000 years old. So I don't know where they found it, but they took the seed and they cut open the shell, okay? And then they took that shell, or they took the seed and they grew it, but then they took the shell and they checked the carbon dating, how old the shell was. And the shell was 2,000 years old, and the lotus still grew. She doesn't know where it is now, but she wonders at the end of the chapter, where is that lotus plant now? And that is how chapter 3 ends. Oh, 2,000 years waiting. Oh, cracked shell. This might have been where she talked about all you have to do is crack a shell of the seed, put a little water, and like almost any seed will grow. Let's look at some vocabulary, because there were some strange words I even had to look up. First one is stoicism. Stoicism is like no emotion. You kind of think like a monk that doesn't want to show anger or sadness, just no emotion. Constituted is like the foundation or the creation. Embryo is a group of cells that are going to start a life form. So it could be a seed, it could be a human baby, could be any kind of thing. But it's like those first few cells together about ready to grow into something. Brazen is bold and confident without caring about yourself in a way. Stultifying is like deadening, keeping from growing or numbing. Interminable is everlasting, ongoing, continual. Copious is large, abundance, many. Euthanized means to kill. So the tree that her parents had and that she loved, when it was fallen over, it was probably still alive. Like there was still some roots, maybe it was still putting some energy to half of the tree or something, but it was too old and it was weak, and so they just killed it. And we often use this word when we have an animal or a human, even in some countries, that are so old they really can't do anything, and we just let them go to sleep and die. Euthanized. Derive means come from. So I think like strawberry juice is derived from strawberries. Okay, maybe something like that. Originates from. I think the last one here is coddled, which is to kind of hold and care for like a baby, to kind of spoil or love or protect. Oh, one more. Replete, which I can't remember what that means at all. So if you know and look it up, please write it in the comments so that way the rest of us can figure out what the meaning of the word is also. Let's go to discussion question. Do you think that the parents just chopped down the spruce? I don't know about you, but sometimes with pets or animals, when kids go on vacation or to camp, they come back and the pet's gone. They say, oh, the pet ran away, or the pet flew away, or something happened. And then the child learns 5 years later, oh, yeah, we killed that thing. Or, oh, we flushed it down the toilet. Or dad didn't want it anymore, so we gave it away. Or whatever it is. I don't know. I just had this weird feeling as I was reading that story. This huge, mighty tree. Sure, limbs breaking in snowstorms, I get it. But the whole tree, like, toppling over? Was that just an excuse from the parents? I don't know. What do you think? Of course, please make your own discussion. Question. That is all the time that we have for today. But thank you so much for joining me for this episode of Book Club Preview. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Hey, if you have any questions about the video today, please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section. If you had any other vocabulary words that you wanted to know what they meant, let me know. And also, if you're interested in maybe joining one of these book clubs, please leave a comment and I'll get back to you. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.